Now, there's no doubt about it that creator Jon Favreau and even Dave Filoni at that are really trying their absolute best to really get Star Wars back on track by bringing in tons of Star Wars legends in the mix, as well as really dragging in a lot of the older stories that a lot of fans really adored throughout the 1990s and the early 2000s. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Also, make sure to check me out at MikeZero1 on Twitter if you would like to. Now, moving past everything related to Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni for a moment, we do know that Kathleen Kennedy is still actively working on the Acolyte TV series with Leslie. Obviously, it's not going too well. There's been a lot of setbacks the past couple of weeks, give or take. A lot of firings of co-writers and some of the directors for certain episodes. A lot of things are happening as we speak, and this is one thing to really take into account. Is that when we look at Kathleen Kennedy, she has done nothing but create damage to the Star Wars universe and really not allowed for the Star Wars fandom to enjoy what they wanted to actually see. So past all of this, we do know that Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni, they are doing everything in their power to bring back Star Wars legends in the mix. And this really does speak volumes. It tells the fans that, well, you know, they do care, they're very passionate, they want to actually fulfill the characters of Luke Skywalker and others out there to actually portray them the way that they were meant to be portrayed, unlike with what happened in The Last Jedi by director Rian Johnson. So, with that being said, when we go ahead and examine what's going to happen this fall. This fall, a lot of major announcements are coming our way. In that November to December time frame, right around those months, is when Disney and Lucasfilm, they're going to drop tons of new TV show announcements and movie announcements as well. And that's also, not to mention that, also more announcements coming our way at Celebration of 22. So, with that being said, as of right now, it's described that creators Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are actively developing their new Star Wars projects that are going to connect to the Mandalorian series and more. This major plan by Favreau is to make sure that he can bring back Star Wars legends in a big way for the entire Star Wars fandom to enjoy. Favreau is said to have already established a major plan to actually recreate Star Wars legends not just in the forms of books and comics, but also transferring over into live-action form. Now, it's noted that recently Favreau hired actress Karen Gillan to become the new Mara Jade in his new Star Wars shows, to act like the new, of course, Mara Jade, with the new young Luke Skywalker as well, which Sebastian Stan is still at the top of the list to be picked for. Favreau is set to incorporate a major story for both Luke and Mara Jade in both The Mandalorian Season 3 and 4 that is going to set up a young Luke Skywalker TV series that is currently dubbed simply as Star Wars Jedi Knight. The Star Wars Jedi Knight series is set to explore a story after Mara Jade has been redeemed from the Mando episodes, and that Mara in the Mando episodes is set to serve as the Emperor's personal assassin, to hunt down both Ahsoka, Luke Skywalker, as well as Ezra Bridger. Now for both Mando Season 3 and 4, Jon and Dave want to make Mara Jade almost like a villain in a sense, that eventually the story, of course, is going to progress to a moment in which there will be a romance between Mara and Luke that will be geared for the planned young Luke Skywalker TV series for Disney Plus that is set to be released on Disney Plus by 2024 and is going to be announced at Star Wars Celebration in 2022. Kathleen Kennedy is described to be against the idea of Favreau restarting Star Wars by bringing back Star Wars legends in the mix and more. So here's a very interesting development. You guys may or may not actually have heard about this, but Brie Larson at one point in time, we talked about this a couple of days ago, she actually auditioned for the role of Mara Jade. It's not that she was picked for the role. She auditioned for it and was actually refused by Jon Favreau. He actually wanted to pick Karen Gillan over Brie Larson. And let me tell you, very smart decision on Jon Favreau's part. I believe that he knows what he's doing. He knows what the fans want to see. And I gotta give props to him for that. When we go ahead and examine everything related to the Star Wars universe and exactly where it's going right now, obviously a lot of fans are very much on edge on whether or not Jon and Dave are going to be able to pull things off. I want to actually dive deeper into Mara Jade. Now, this actual plan for Mara Jade in the Mando episodes, or the Mando seasons, I should say, to have her serve more around the lines of a villain is a very interesting setup. So basically what they're going to do is that they're going to make her pretty much the Emperor's personal assassin to hunt down the remaining Force Sensitives and or Jedi. We're talking about Luke, Ezra, Ahsoka, and others out there. That's a very interesting way to actually give Mara Jade the proper character development that she needs that's going to eventually make her way into the young Luke Skywalker TV series for Disney Plus in the next couple of years. I like how it's currently dubbed as simply Jedi Knight. It's kind of a little bit of a nod to the old school video games out there, but I digress. The other thing that really does surprise me the most about this is how, yes, they are going to actually revive that romance story between Luke and Mara. Something that you would have never expected Disney to allow, but they are allowing Jon Favreau to do this. Favreau is making sure to restart Star Wars as a whole by bringing back Star Wars Legends and basically putting it back into full swing. I think that's a very good move by Favreau. This is a big win for the Star Wars fandom. It just shows that Favreau really wants to have a major victory when it comes to Star Wars, to really create his own legacy, if you will. I mean, I don't think he's in it just to create his own legacy. He's obviously a fan. He's a very passionate creator. He knows what he's doing. So it's all a matter of exactly, you know, whether or not they can pull it off. I do believe that they will. I don't believe they're going to make any drastic mistakes at that. They're going to most likely stay directly in line with the continuity and how Star Wars Legends actually told these stories. There may be some minor differences, obviously, to kind of make it leveled out with the sequel trilogy a little bit out there. But overall, Mando Season 3 and 4 and future Star Wars TV shows, this is a big deal because this is John and Dave's way of redeeming Star Wars, of really bringing it back in action. And I respect that. You know, I really do respect that. I do believe that when we go ahead and examine, you know, what John and Dave have done the past couple of months, I mean, we saw what they did with the Mandalorian Season 2 finale by saving the character of Luke and really bringing him back into full action the way that he deserved to be. It just goes to show you that they can make things right, they can make things work, if nobody gets in the way like Kathleen Kennedy did. So, like I've said before, you know, I think that obviously this is going to really unfold in the next couple of months. Again, this fall, we're going to be learning more about what Legend stories are coming back and how it's going to be done and what TV shows and more. So, like I've said, you know, drop a comment below. Let me know about all of this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.